up, beautiful family? How are you all doing? Thank you so dearly for always tuning in. I really appreciate. Today, the first time you are coming across us, so you are hearing this voice for the first time. We still remain progressing and we give you all the latest updates. Remember, in this platform, we react to all videos and your opinion is highly needed. So sit back, watch this video, and I'll be right back.
War. It was not war. Ojukwu did not start the war, as they claim that Ojukwu started the war. Ojukwu never campaigned for war. Ojukwu never campaigned for separation. Ojukwu have never campaigned for separation. Go and read the history. And that is why they deny you history, for them to bend their belief into your belief. For them to force you to believe their lies and call it history. The same way a white man who colonize you now bring your Bible to force you to believe their lies written in the Bible in order to, manage your mindset. The only way somebody can control you is when he get access to your mindset. When somebody have full access to your mindset, he will control you and you become his toy, a robot. Now, simple question. Why do you colonize us before you now bring out Bible? And who wrote Bible? I call it slave book. It is what they use to control your mindset. The same way they are using Quran to control the poor masses that are Muslim mindset. The same way they are using Bible to control the poor Christian mindset. That you might not think well, that you might lose focus, that you might lose your identity. Yes. If you are a Christian or a Muslim, I owe you no apology. Muslims say kill. Christians say don't kill. But there is something I want to pick out for you, Christianity. The kingdom of God suffered violence, and the violent take it by force. For those of you who are preaching peace, what happened in Aburi Akor in Ghana? If you ask them, they say Ojukwu started the war. If you ask them, they say Ojukwu pre-secessionist. If you ask them, they will tell you so many lies. And for you to believe their lies, they remove the history in curriculums. And whatever thing they talk, you will believe. Fulani are evil. But let me shock you. I don't want to go into deep. Go and Google Aburi Akor and read the history. There in Aburi Akor, they agree in restructuring through federalism. And through federalism was what existed when the colonial master newly hand over the power to Fulani originally in 1960. The three regional, which is Hausa, Fulani, Igbo, everybody were managing their resources, everybody were governing themselves, but there is one federalism, and then was through federalism. And that was when Naira was really having value until the evil that would destroy Nigeria, or that is destroying Nigeria today, entered the mind of the colonial master. Where they say, why are you allowing these people to get their way? Before you know, Igbo man will take everything from you. So start intimidating them, start killing them, and then bring out federal that will be controlling every other state, and let that federal center in Abuja, which simply means that Nigeria is your own, so that you can control them in political way, in every way. If you don't do like this, Igbo will come and take over everything. The colonial master starting injecting fair root in Fulani, they start working according to that. And Igbo were killed in so many places in North. Out of the killing, Ojukwu said, we have to return back to the way we were before. The killing is too much. And that was the reason they went to Ghana to agree. Gowon agree. Others agree with agreement between them. Say, okay, let's go back and then keep to the agreement so that we keep working as one. Nigeria failed to keep to that agreement. Believe you me, agreement is agreement. Whosoever that failed to keep his own part of agreement is guilty. But today, Nigeria, did they accept being guilty? Even when they killed 30 million of Biafrans, did they accept being guilty? No. Instead of them to accept their guilty or their fault, and then find way to apologize and see how they can amend from evil way. You remember the last one I told you that the evil man will always think the way to cover up his evil. I'm trying to cover up your evil, you keep committing crime upon crime. That is exactly what Nigeria is doing. And so therefore, Ojugu asking them to do the agreement, they start killing, and that led to war. The question I'm asking you is, if you were Ojugu, when people are killing your own people, will you keep quiet and allow them to wipe out your people? Just a simple question. Aburi Akol. Returning Nigeria back to this former stage, which is true federalism, where the federal character will appear in every region or tribe. Today, we do not have any federal presence in South, South, and Southeast. Please, if you have seen any road constructed by federal government in South, South, and Southeast, let me know. If you have seen any federal presence in South, South, and Southeast, let me know. Do we have any company that built by federal government in South, South, and Southeast? You are also there to educate me. In case I didn't know, please, I'm stand to be corrected. Let me tell you, Nnamdi Kanu came up. Did Nnamdi Kanu preach secessionists? No. He gave them option. What led to the coming of Nnamdi Kanu? It is because of the marginalization of Ndi Igbo or Biafran people. What did they do? They bring Python dance. Before Python dance, did Biafran carry weapon? No. I'm showing you the fact that Nigeria does not like peace. They don't know peace. They don't want peace. So when you are coming to preach peace, you are idiot. You are very stupid. You don't know anything. Because what Nigeria understands is violence. And that is why God say, the kingdom of Biafra, sovereign violence, and violence will take it by force. It started from the beginning. It was violence. And do you see why we will never bow down to Fulani request? Do you see why peace will never reign in Nigeria? The reason why I'm saying this to you is for those of you who are believing in peace to start planning for war so that you will not get yourself killed. You can only preach peace for the person who wants peace. You can't go and preach peace for the person who know nothing about peace, who does not believe in peace. And you go and preach peace. Did Nigeria know what is peace? They did not keep the peaceful agreement between Gowon and Ojukwu that was witnessed by Ghanaian president. They did not keep the peaceful agreement. They did not keep the peaceful agitation of Nnamdi Kanu IPOB. They did not. What make you think that same people will keep the peaceful agreement if the Prime Minister, Simon Ekpa, decided to enter in peaceful and negotiation with them? He can never work now. They did not keep that of Ojukwu. They did not keep that of Nnamdi Kanu. Are you not aware that Nnamdi Kanu has meeting with all the South, South, Southeast governors? Are you not aware of that? Nnamdi Kanu has meeting with all the governors of South, South, and Southeast. What was his demand? Did they keep to that peace? Are you not also aware that late Yaradua, Mama late Buhari, went to prison to see Nnamdi Kanu? Are you not informed of that? There will be nothing like peace. Let me tell you this. See, some of you hate truth. Many of you love when somebody came and tell you lies, you believe that lies. That is why your pastor is using your brain to smoke. Because you believe in miracle and prophecy. Fake prophecy. I saw peace. God spoke to me. The Spirit of the Lord came and visited me and he messaged me. This is the message. In 2024, there will be peace in Nigeria and everything will be normal. That is what you love. And you will not even gather courage to confront that your pastor. At the end of the day, when 2024 finished, and what that pastor prophesied, saying that it is the Lord that revealed to him, said, and it did not happen. You will not even have courage to confront that pastor and say, Pastor, the past year, this is what you said. And you say that is the Lord that said. Does the Lord lie? None of you will go back. So pastor will concur. Having seen that nobody challenged the lie he lied previously, he will concur another lie and knock on your head. And your brain will absorb it. And you keep growing, believing in lies. And they keep feeding you with lies because that is what you like. But if any person come to you and tell you, my dear, let's prepare for war. At the look of things, Nigeria will break up through war. You say, don't, God forbid. God forbid. We cannot fight war again. God forbid. And that is why idiot call Ikenka, whatever. Who say that? I hear one of his girls say, I've told them that if this agitation will lead to violence, I'm not in support of violence. But the kingdom of Biafra survived violence, and the violence take it by force. Nnamdi Kanu preached peace. He have never advocated for violence. Do you know that even when boys in Umuahia, when army man, policemen came to disrupt boys that was in Nnamdi Kanu house, boys out of anger confronted them, seized their weapon, and bring them down to Nnamdi Kanu house. Do you know the command he gave to them? To return those things back to them. And every damn thing was returned back to them. Which means this man was a peace advocate. He only called for referendum. He said, let's conduct referendum. It's referendum. It's a call for referendum, a call for war. If I don't know, please let me know. When did the call for referendum become the call for war? Until you introduce Python Dance 1, Python Dance 2, and 3. Killing innocent people. The question I want to ask you again, which is the second question. If you were Nnamdi Kanu, will you keep quiet for your enemy or those who claim to be your the countrymen, your fellow countrymen, to kill your men? Having seen them killing your men, will you keep quiet? Lastly, the man that had been preaching for peace, then kidnap him down to Nigeria, deny him access. He's supposed to be in prison. They refuse to take him to prison. Then keep him in the dark room in government property known as Government Enforcement, DSS. Having kidnapped peacemaker, what do you expect? If you want beam, if you are looking for trouble, then you want being to you know sting you, go to being honeycomb and throw them something or put your hand, what you will see, you will live to testify. You cannot find person trouble and you expect that person to keep quiet. The same way I normally say, you can't beat a child and you do not expect that child to cry. When you beat a child and the child start crying and you begin to say, why are you crying? Shut up. The child cry because you beat a child. Why are we today carrying weapon? It's because we do not want that killing anymore. It's because we don't want to die again. It's because we value our life. And it's because you have pushed us to the point whereby we need to defend ourselves. That is why we carry weapon. We do not just stay on our own and go and carry weapon. Biafrans today does not just carry weapon because they won't carry weapon. The same way you left Ojukwu with no other option than to defend the land of Biafra, which you came to and commit genocide that the world refused to talk about. Have you stopped killing Biafrans? Today, Boko Haram is going around freely killing. The one you managed to arrest, you put them back to army and send them to East, make them come kill. Beta killing. License of killing. Biafrans. Now the question I want to ask you is, were you thinking that we will fold our hand and remain as a dummy for you to keep killing us? I will tell you this afternoon that indeed you do not know what is coming. You do not know what is coming. It was you that bring weapon that we are using. Nnamdi Kanu never buy us weapon. It was you that brought weapon that we are using to defend ourselves, because we must defend ourselves and our land. We must defend our life. It is a must, or we die defending our life and our land. We cannot no longer allow you to kill us as will, as you like. No. That errands have gone. So you that is talking about peace, who caused war? And if you realize that it is Nigeria that is causing this war, what is the best thing? The best advice you can give them? Is it the same thing we have been talking of? Leave Biafra territory. Stay on your territory and let's discuss in peaceful way. If you agree, then let's discuss in peaceful way. But you say no. You want to force us. You want to force us to accept Nigeria by fire, by force. We will all die here. Believe you me. Our children and our children unborn will continue fighting this war. If God failed to give us Biafra, for your information, they will never bow down for you. They will never bow down for you. They will never accept to be Nigeria. Do you think our children does not know? We croon them. We educate them. We inform them. We show them who is their enemies. They knew those who are their enemy. They knew. Okay, now let me ask you. Your police recruitment, how many Biafrans join? Your secret army recruitment, how many Biafrans join? If Ador are refusing to join your Islamic war that you are building to come and destroy their own people, what make you think that our children do not know who is their enemy? So, that is what I'm saying. The kingdom of Biafra suffered violence, and the violence take it by force. Nigeria doesn't need peace. Nigeria does not believe in peace. So let's see in the battlefield. when you are talking about insecurity in the South, South, and Southeast, I want to ask you a very simple question this afternoon. Who brought insecurity to the South, South, and Southeast? Have you not been hearing about Ruger taking people land by force and give to Fulani? And when the people, the villagers, say no, Fulani will go into that land with their fowl, killing them at will, raping their women, raping their daughters, killing their men, burning down their houses. Have you ever heard in any court in Nigeria that those who committed those atrocities have been comprehended? Please, if you have heard any, let me know. I'm stand to be corrected. Who brought insecurity? Our women were no longer farming. Fulani was gradually taking over our forests, our farmland, knowing fully well that those are the means of surviving. Do you think it could have been safe or right for the great man like Nnamdi Kanu to keep quiet while his people are being butchered, killed, and kidnapped every day and day? Answer me. I'm talking about those who believe in peaceful way of separation. Please answer me. Having kidnapped Nnamdi Kanu, who was a peaceful advocate, who does not believe in violence, who are always called for referendum, have you not heard they came up and boast that indeed they have conquered Biafra once again? That made them to say that Biafra is dead and buried? Obasanjo was part of those who killed Biafrans. Babangida was part of those who killed Biafran. Gowon was part of those who killed Biafrans. And they were all in that meeting. And those who love selling their people, and they say Biafra is dead and buried. That was their thought. Now I want them to think and think very well if what they said is really reality. Is Biafra dead and buried? Is Biafra dead and buried? They never see something. Peace can never exist because Nigeria know nothing about peace. Just as our Prime Minister said, once Biafra is being declared to restore its territory, it's going to be so brutal. And that is when you believe that part of your slave book that say the kingdom of Biafra suffered violence and the violence take it by force. Do you understand me? You will believe that very line of words. You will believe it. You are going to understand it very clear. That is why when I come, each time I come, I will tell you one thing. If you do not take anything from this, from me, from my broadcast, please take one simple thing. And that is get yourself prepared for what is to come. Because this rain that is gathering, it must surely fall. Today, Soludo come up. Illegitimate governor of Anambra State, the former Anambra State, come up and then is talking nonsense. And today, just the same way Hope Uzodinma was moving, he have deployed 40 armored tank and many personnel. He have hired so many machinery through federal government of Islamic State of Nigeria, come to Anambra, prepare to come and launch attack. And just yesterday, I told him, Soludo, go and ask questions. Because the front line will soon be open in Anambra. So you that is talking about peace, when it start happening, you see come and say, Biafra army do this, Biafra army do this. But who start them in the first place? It's always a simple question. You will not start something. And when somebody... defend himself. You now say, okay, I shouldn't defend myself. For me to be peaceful, then bring war. I should not defend myself and fight them. I should not defend my life. Okay, for me to be peaceful person, Abi, thunder fire you. Chuku, wogioku. Na mi tokam. So, na them worry to live. Okay, God created me to die, Abi. Okay, He created them to live. He created me for experiment, where they can experiment it and kill as they like. One thing they do not know is that waiting kill our papa, no fit kill us. The mistake our father make can never be repeated. Why did I say the mistake our father make can never be repeated in this our generation? We have seen the mistake our father make. The worst mistake they make was to surrender, to agree on that nonsense trap, no victory, no banquet. That was the worst mistake they make. We have learned from their mistake. And that mistake must be corrected by us. Okay? We don't want Nigeria. It is not by force to be won. And that is why I say, even though it will take 1 million years, this war will never end. It can never end in peace. At the end of the war, have this in mind, that Biafra must be emerged victoriously. You can't stop it. They never born you to stop it. They never born you to stop it. Write it down. So, Soludo, we are aware of all the armor town, the latest armor town that you brought. Yes, welcome. Welcome to the battlefield. We are going to tune another battlefield, face Anambra, very, very sharply. Those who are staying in old Anambra, this message is truly for you. Get prepared. Another battlefield is going to open in Anambra, old Anambra state, because the illegitimate governors of old Anambra state decided to kill our people, to bring war to our land, and we will not allow that to happen. We will protect the land of Biafra with all the strength in us, with our life. We will protect the life of every Biafran in Biafran territory with every strength in our life. So please be careful. When you hear the sound of gun, lie down, find a bush around you and enter for your safety. We are opening a battlefield in Anambra because we will not allow Soludo to use the Islamic forces of Nigeria to kill our youth, burn our houses. It won't happen again. Not at this time. And we will never bow down. We will never surrender to anybody until Biafra is fully restored back to its glory. Share this message. To all the people in Anambra state. It can happen any moment from now. As I'm talking to you, it have already started. It has already started. So, get prepared. Please. The same thing I told you goes to every Biafran. In all territory that belongs to Biafra, retrieve your movement at night and be very careful, be vigilant. Never forget that this kingdom of Biafra suffered violence, and violence will take it by force. Same way we tell you before, hope have tired, resign, hand over to Soludo, but we will force Soludo to bow down because this is our land. And let me tell you, this land is our right, our heritage, our portion. And in this land, whom our great-grandfather hand over to our father, that hand over to us, we go nowhere. We go nowhere. We will fight them and down because we have taken an oath to hand over this land to our children and our children's children in peace and in harmony without the presence of the terrorists. I will be back. Okay? Tell them this, that the mistake our forefather make, that mistake, we are going to correct that mistake. Tell them that we have seen the mistake and we will correct that mistake. Because it is either Biafra or Biafra. No two ways about it. Go and get yourself prepared. I don't intend to pass this very minute. And I would like to say good afternoon once again to the lovers of freedom and to every true child of Biafrans. And don't believe you me, I don't preach peace. And I will say very bad day to the enemies of Biafra. They will never see peace. Nigeria will never see peace. They have killed so many lives. Nigeria have wasted so many lives. So many innocent lives. Nigerians have wasted so many dreams. Nigeria is evil. If you did not destroy this evil will destroy you. Then the last question before I quit for today is, will you allow this evil called Nigeria to destroy you? Give me that answer in the comment section. I am waiting for you. See you next time. Let's go back and tell Soludo that this thing you are about to start, can you stand and finish it? Also help me ask Soludo. Now yesterday I asked Soludo, have you asked question? A person who knows ask question who always lost. Soludo, go and ask Hope question. But please, if you are from Anambra, ask Soludo. Oga, this thing you are about to start, can you stand and finish it? Because it's not the matter of starting, it's the matter of finishing it. Not he who started. Have capacity to end it. But help me, Hassan. This war line you want to open in Anambra, can you stand and finish it? Because at the end, all must help Biafra. Because it's the end point. You must bow down for Biafra. Don't forget, Biafra is the kingdom of Chukwukike Abiama on earth. And it is our religion. It is our tradition. And it is our heritage. It is our hope. So when you come thinking that you can stop us, it's running in our blood. It is the blood that flows within our body. And you cannot do anything about it. Thank you very much. Let this message go far and near until it reaches Soludo. Until it reaches Soludo, not just Soludo, all the governors of South, South, and Southeast, the illegitimate governors. Let it reach all the territory of Biafra so that as you are preparing, they will also get prepared. Because this rain that is gathering, it must fall. This is our heritage. We go nowhere.
So, my wonderful family, that brings us to the end of this update. Do what to like the video, share, and subscribe. Thank you, and bye-bye.